the Lord and good evening. Thank you for joining us today. Today is one of those historical days here in our nation, Kenya. The day that we have gone and really exercised our civic duty to vote for the next leadership of this country. So welcome to our service tonight. We pray that in our time of worship together, the Lord will be lifted above all else, above our circumstances, above our fears, and above our worries, and even above our nation. And so I'll make a prayer, and as we begin, then we'll be joined by this wonderful band, this wonderful team, Benefit Experience Band, that will lead us in a time of worship and to have our attention to just be focused on God. Father, we want to thank you. We want to bless you. And as we begin our time together this evening, this ninth day of August 2022, where perhaps some polling stations have closed, maybe some results are trickling in, Father, we want to shift our attention to you, because you are a sovereign God. And you tell us again in your word that the steps of the righteous is ordered by God. We surrender ourselves to you. Will you alone be exalted in our worship? For again you tell us that you inhabit, you dwell the praises of your people. This, Lord, we ask, trusting and believing in Jesus' name.
Feel free and join us in worship even as you're taking your tea, as you sit and watching.
Bye.
come and sing.
Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Wanna break every chain.
Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
In your presence, break Lord, every chain is broken, every bone is broken. One more time, say break,
break every chain. Break every chain.
At your name, Jesus, every knee will bow. Every tongue confess that you are Lord. Come on, one more time, say,
break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every
chain.
Anani.
Jali.
Anani.
Jali.
Sitoku. Kuzama
kwenye maji
anani
penda
yeyeni
wemba
anani
chali
anani
chali
sito for the nation one more time, just one more time. Anatu
Chali,
Anatu
Chali,
Anatu Toku
Bali,
Kuzama
kwenye maji,
Anatu
Penda Wema.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Father, we that abide in you, O God, under the shadow of your wings, we shall always be safe. That's our prayer, O God, as Kenyan, that we are safe under the shadow of your wings. No plans of the enemy, no plans of any wicked politician, any wicked fanatics, O God, shall prosper in this holy nation. For at the mention of your name, Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that you are Lord. Worthy is the Lamb. And at the mention of the blood of the Lamb, the works of the enemy are defeated. The works of the enemy are destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
I know a place I can always run. In times of distress, confusion and fear, when the enemy surrounds me, I know in you I'm safe. For you keep me and hide me in the shadow of your wings. I know a place I can always run to. In times of distress, confusion and fear, when my enemy surrounds me, I know in you I'm safe. For you keep me and hide me in the shadow of your wings. In the shadow of your wings, I know I am safe. In the shadow of your wings, I find relief. For you will hold me and you'll guide me with your righteous hand. I find rest, peace of mind. In the shadow of your wings.
Come on, help me, Jude.
In the shadow of your wings, I know I am safe. In the shadow of your wings.
lead a personal prayer for Kenya and say,
Kenya is safe in the shadow of your wings. We are safe
in the shadow of your wings.
Say, we are safe in the shadow.
We are safe
in the shadow.
In the shadow of your wings.
No, Kenya is safe.
We are safe
in the shadow.
In the shadow.
Say we are safe.
We are safe
in the shadow.
In the shadow of your wings.
We're so safe in the shadow.
We are safe
in the
shadow of your wings.
Say we are safe.
We are safe
in the shadow.
In the shadow of your wings. We are safe.
As a nation, we are so safe in the shadow of your wings. We want to pray for your guidance as we vote, guidance as we count, guidance as we wait, and guide us as we inaugurate our new leaders, oh God. And more importantly, enable us to live in love with our neighbor, oh God, just as we love ourselves, oh God. Enable us, oh God, to live in peace, love, and unity. Take back every hate speech, every hate message that has been sent, posted, replied. Every negative comment that has been spoken against the country. Father, may you restore us, oh God. May you hold us together and may you bind us with your love, with cords that cannot be broken. In the mighty name of Jesus. I believe. And God's people said, amen. Amen.
Thank you.
good evening. It's just around, you know, a few minutes past six. You're probably sipping some coffee in your house after a day of some queuing, a day of some watching the news as the results are beginning to trickle in. And you're probably wondering, what is the next step? Well, I want to share a few things with you. My name is Munengi Mulandi from Nairobi Baptist. I am having my coffee in the church as I share what I hope will be a word of encouragement for you as we consider what are our next steps. What do we do after such a day like today? I hope you had a pleasant day. I hope that, you know, the Lord blessed you wherever you went to cast your vote, and you're just relaxing at home. But one of the things I wanted to encourage you, let's not waste this time. Let's not just be flipping from channel to channel. You know, what is Pokot East, Pokot West, and what's happening in Kilungu. You know, let's. It takes a few hours. It takes a few days for us to have the results come in. Let's not raise our blood pressure by, you know, being glued to our TV, social media. Who has said what? Have they admitted? No. Let's be guided by the word of God. Allow me to read the Psalms. Psalms 37, verse 23. Let me give you a minute to find it. Psalms 37, verse 23. This is one of my most encouraging verses in the Psalms. This is my go-to psalm when things are a little hazy. This is what the psalm says. Psalms 37, verse 23. Every step of a righteous man is ordered by the Lord. I wish I had time to tell you all what that means to me when I just read that verse. Allow me just to kind of underline, underscore, highlight a few words. This is not talking about one or two of the five steps that somebody takes. It is saying every single step. And it's just not of Tom, Dick, and Harry, Wajiko, and Wagare, and Nekesa. No. It's each and every step of a righteous Wagare, of a righteous Chalo, of a righteous Okech. Every step of a righteous man is ordered by God. It's not a matter of by chance, you know, perhaps peradventure. No. Every single step of a righteous man is ordered by God. Now, I wish I could tell you that I learned this verse from a deep time, you know, of studying or reading God's word. It was actually one of our gospel musicians, Fred Hammond, who has a lovely song. It goes so slow that it helps you just internalize that every step of a righteous man. When I heard the song, I went straight to look, what scripture is that? And I found it in Psalms 37, verse 23. There are several things that I like about this, that are highlighted about this verse. The first thing is the sovereignty of God. God is not somewhere in the psalmist's issues and his pandashukas of life. God is not somewhere licking his finger and trying to find where the political winds, where the, you know, inflation winds are facing to be able to intervene. No, no, no. The picture is a God who is in heaven, seated on his throne in total relaxation because he is in control. He is completely sovereign over the issues that are happening. And it says he's not just seated up there in heaven, you know, with all the things surrounding him in order, praise and worship. He's concerned about what happens to this psalmist, to this believer down there, to you and I, who are wondering, is this Kenya, Jero? You know what's going to happen to Kenya tomorrow? You know, and all that, and my, you know, my MP, my party, my presidential candidate, God is on his throne, high up, but not aloof, not distant from us, involved that every step that we take is ordered.
You know, if I was a musician, I would really have sung that chorus of how ordered our lives are, because our sovereign God up there is concerned about every single step. Therefore, if you are a believer, you cannot have a misstep. Nilikanyaga vibaya. No, can't happen. Because your steps are not a combination of how the muscles below your knee and above your knee coordinate. Mm-mm. It's about that there is one who sits sovereignly on his throne, but concerned about, you know, issues, minute issues. It doesn't say, you know, oh, your walk is determined by the Lord. Mm-mm. It goes to the granular. Every step of a righteous man is ordered. You know, I wish you had an opportunity from home to shout hallelujah, because there is no better security for you and I at a few minutes to seven on election day, when we don't know the full results. Will it be 50 plus one? Will it be? Could it be? Those worries can be stilled when we know that every step of a righteous man is ordered. Now, I need to break that word down, because I like it. Ordered is not suggested, you know? Every step is not suggested by the Lord. Every step is not prescribed. You know, prescription, you know how you're written for, take three Panadols three times a day. By second day, if you're not having a headache, you don't go to the pharmacy or the chemist to get any more. It's a prescription. It's almost like a strong suggestion. This is not a suggestion. It's not a prescription. It is an order by the sovereign one. Every step of a righteous man is ordered by the Lord. Will you allow me to suggest four steps that the righteous can do at this time? Four steps that each righteous person can take for these days, so that we don't waste our time in worry, so that we don't waste our time in anxiety, and so that we just don't waste God's time because we are waiting for the country to settle after the results come out. We are waiting for the results, then we settle. No. If every step of the righteous is ordered by God, it means there are steps you and I can take under that sovereign God to his glory and make this time significant. First, step number one. I want to suggest to you, my brothers and sisters, step number one, which is ordered by the Lord, thanksgiving. Some of us today had some long queues. Some of us had queues in the cold. Some of us had queues in the hot sun. And it's 6 p.m. and you're just thinking, all I need is just some rest. I'm so angry, I don't even know why I went. You know, you went and your name was missing. It took 45 minutes to find your name. Ad infinitum, ad nauseam. The day is coming to an end. Step number one, just thank God for today. Thank God for today that we can communicate that you finished that exercise. Some of you listening to me, you did not have a voter's card because perhaps you're not Kenyan, because perhaps you are younger or you lost it, etc. But all of us can gather in our different places, in our different homes, in our different situations today, and just thank God that today began and today ended. It came to pass. This big day, August the 9th, is now evening. It's time to give thanks that this day has come and has ended. You can sneak in another thanksgiving there, that the days of politicking and all the political, you know, this, that, and the other, and some of the rough exchanges, by God's grace, are finished. Give thanks. Step number two. Pray for those whose work is just intensifying now. There are men and women, gallant men and women of this nation, who have put in their names to be election officials, all the way from Chairman Chebukati in IBC, All the way the CEO and the different polling station, you know, clerks, observers from out of the country, you know, agents from all over, anxious aspirants. I don't think they are called aspirants today. They are called ex-aspirants, you know. Why don't you just pray for those people whose work has just intensified? Because they are under the cameras, they need to work very fast, because the more the election results are delayed, the more the tension in the nation. Why don't you take step number two and pray for them as they work under hard pressure? You know, a lot of pressure, but also under cameras, because their integrity means everything. If you put a ballot box by mistake 3 millimeters to the right of where it's supposed to be, oh, that's an election fraud. You know, they are working under very tough conditions. Why don't you pray for them? Step number three, we're talking about steps of the righteous at this time that are ordered by God. Step number one, thanksgiving for today. Step number two, praying for those who are working after the ballot, and they'll be working for several days. Pray for them. Pray for those who, you know, when there are, you know, issues here and there, you know, connectivity and, you know, all pray for them. Step number three, pray for those that will win. You know, in just a few days, we are going to have winners. You know, MP mtarajiwa. You know, MCA incoming. I pray that we'll take time to join those people and thank God with them. They are going to have a myriad of parties, homecoming, Thanksgiving. As believers, as a righteous person, the Lord has ordered you, step three, to give thanks with them. Go there for those thanksgivings. Many of them are turned into chest thumping because you're absent. What if you went there and you said, Twasema asante? Everybody will join you. And turn that thing that is focused on a woman or a man, turn it to give glory to God that gave them the victory. But also, we are, unfortunately, the reality of life. As much as we have winners, we are going to have many more losers. You know, the presidential aspirants, well, how many? Hadn't they passed several? How many did you see on your ballot? However, the president of Kenya is not going to be on a quarterly basis. You rule for 4 months, you rule for, it's going to be one winner. Many MCAs, many MPs, many aspiring women representatives, many governors who knew, and people had told them, you are the one. Their agents had told them, niwewe tu. They had masses upon masses of people, but then 6 votes. Walk with those people. Go to the house of mourning. Don't say too much. That's not the time for saying, you know, it was a fair fight, it's just that the other person won. Don't, just be silent. There are facts. They can read the facts for themselves. Don't overindulge in the facts. The facts can be read. Just be there for them in silence. Make some continuous flow of tea for them. Arrive with some mandazi kaimati if you are a little more complicated. And just sit with them. And sometimes you go to their home and they are staying in the bedroom. You yuko at the tent that was supposed to be for rejoicing. But arrive there. Whether you voted for them or not, let the Lord, you know, direct your steps, order your steps, that you go to those who are having a hard time accepting the facts and the realities. Some of them had been assured by men and women of God like me that the Lord showed me is you. And I'm not saying that all prophecies are wrong or fail, but I'm just saying maybe they had seen victory for you in 5 years to come. The next election is you, but they didn't tell you the timing. They didn't know the timing. Go to those homes. Go to those party headquarters and just sit with them like Job's friends did for the first 7 days. No words. And then encourage those you have access to be that saying that we've heard so many times, magnanimous in victory, indeed giving thanks, but humbly, not chest thumping. That's for gorillas. Just humbly accepting, I won, but my competitors gave me, you know, good company to the ballot box, and they really gave me a chase. By the grace of God, I got it. But all of you in this constituency, all of you who voted, please know that I will represent you. And our brothers and sisters who didn't make it, let's pray that they would get, you know, significant things to do even as they look forward to their time in office. Magnanimous in victory and gracious in defeat. Don't say, you know, it's because of the weather. Most of my voters, they have asthma. If they had come, I would have shown. No, 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 no. The poll does not take asthma or non-asthma. You lost. Just accept it. And family, let's surround those people. Every step of a righteous man is ordered. Ordered. Not suggested. Is ordered by God. Last step. Step number four. Rest tonight. Tuesday, I'm asking us on the 9th, we have dedicated it this evening to just be resting. After this, I'm just going to go and lie down and rest, because it's been a long time of, you know, of concerted prayer, of, you know, listening to things that burn your ears and injure your heart. Good promises that sometimes you wonder, will they really work? But now, tonight, rest. But tomorrow, as the factory settings of our nation are reset, as we begin a very new journey in Kenya, take a new step. After resting, begin to sow for the new future of Kenya. It will take several days for the new administration to organize themselves. Take time to sow a seed in your investment. Take time. Don't take the whole week just resting. No. It's time to build Kenya, and it requires you. I am told by those who've done a little more research than I have done that immediately the results were announced, while people were waiting for what the new government will do 100 days after being installed, there were people who are already planning the Anglo-leasing, you know, corruption deal. Why were they able to do these corrupt things? Because believers had not taken a step number four. The step number four of being at the place of work, at being at the place of business, at being, you know, at your guard place. The gates had been left open, and it was free for all. Do you know how much money we lost in Goldenberg, in Anglo leasing, in all these scandals? Some of them I cannot mention because they are still in court. We are being told that no money was stolen. Yet our eyes seem to say something else, but we do have to wait for courts to determine this. Well, I'm urging you, believers, let's limit our time on the news. In fact, I'd like to suggest, this is just my suggestion, watch the updates of the elections 3 times a day. Anytime you're eating breakfast, lunch, dinner, take a few minutes to see the update. After that, get back to sweating to build this nation. For God is doing something new, but he has ordered every step of a righteous man or woman in this nation to bring something new. The thing we prayed for, you and I have to invest in it by prayer. It is said of our dear brother Isaac of old that in that same year of famine, Genesis 2:6, he planted, put seeds in the ground. While people are talking, huh?
huku unajua kujanyesha na kwambia huku elections bado, you know, complaining and cheap talk about what is happening. He planted, and that same year harvested 100-fold. I proclaim by God's grace prosperity in this nation, because that's our national prayer. Oh God of all creation, bless this our land and nation. That's our prayer today. And the answer to that prayer will be as you and I, believers, recognize these four steps, because every step of a righteous man is ordered. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
We've gone through harsh economical times the past few months, and we just want to put our hope in Jehovah, for He is Jireh, our provider. In the song that says, "Wait on the Lord," originally by Joyous Celebration, but we as a band took it and did something with the verses. We hope that you'll be blessed by it.
I wanna wait on you all the days of my life. But at times tides come by, wear me down, so down.
Fill my cup,
cause I'm empty.
Renew my strength,
cause I'm weary.
Fill me with your presence, oh Lord,
cause it's the fullness of a joy. He knows what you need.
He knows what you need.
He will give it to you just in time.
He will give it to you just in time. Wait on the Lord.
They that wait upon the Lord,
they that wait upon the
shall renew their strength.
Shall renew their strength.
They shall mount up.
They shall mount up.
Turn to weeks, months, seasons, years and years. And Lord, I'm waiting, Lord, I'm waiting on you.
Fill my cup,
cause I'm empty.
Renew my strength,
cause I'm weary.
Fill me with your presence, oh Lord,
cause it's the fullness of a child. What you need,
He knows what you
He
need.
Will give it to you.
He will give it to you just in time. Wait on the Lord.
They that wait upon,
they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
They shall mount up.
That we're gonna wait on you. We'll put our trust in you, for you are Jireh, our provider. Hallelujah. And that's our cry today. Sopranos, can you guide us and sing?
Wait.
Altos, can you guide us and sing? One and only tenor.
Everybody join in and sing. Wait, 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 wait.
Jesus, thank you, Jesus. Hey.
Each and every family, oh God, each and every household, oh God, may you provide, may you come through, oh God, through each and every season, whether it's a season of abundance, season of lack, season of promotion, of rejection, oh God, may you come through for each and everybody who's waiting upon you. We lift our hands, oh God, and we declare that we put our trust in you. For some trust in chariots, some trust in their finances, some trust in their political candidates, but we shall put our hope and our trust in you, child. Can we just take the chorus one more time?
Wait on the Lord. He knows what you need. He will give it to you just in time. Wait on the Lord.
Hey, then
wait. Hey, then wait. Shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. Wait on the Lord.
Wait on the Lord.
Wait on the Lord.
He knows what you need.
He knows what you need.
He will come through.
He will give it to you just in time. Wait on the Lord.
They that wait upon you.
They that wait. Shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. Wait on the
forevermore.
For the next song, I just need you to get a neighbor next to you in the sitting room. If you're watching it in the living room, gazebo, corridor, whatever you're watching, wherever you're watching us from and worshiping with us. In 1 Corinthians 12, verses 12 to 27, talks about us being different parts, yet one body in Christ. And that's all we want to sing today as we declare love for each other as a people and as a nation and as a country.
Going up one more time.
Survive, I pray.
love you.
I love you.
Can we do it without any music?
Survive. I pray for you.
And you pray for me.
You pray for me.
Said I love you.
I love you. I need you to survive.
I won't harm you.
I won't harm you with words from my mouth. I love you. I need you to survive.
One more time.
Survive.
I pray for you.
I pray
and you
for
pray
you.
For me.
So our Father and our God, we want to thank you. Because without you, O Lord, we can do absolutely nothing. Lord, we need you to be able to survive. We need you, Lord, to be able to do that which we do in our lives. And so, Father, even with this election, Lord, we need you as a nation and as a people. Thank you, Jesus, for reminding us this evening that indeed you order the steps of the righteous. That, Lord, you are a sovereign God. That nothing catches you by surprise. That, Lord, even as we've gone and as we've done our civic duties, Lord, to vote, Lord, it will not catch you by surprise, the turnout of this election. You are a sovereign God. And you order our steps. Lord, ours is to be so close to you, to hear you, to follow you. And after all is said and done, we will say that indeed the Lord has watched over our nation. Above everything, Lord, we pray for the peace of this nation. Above everything, Lord, we pray for the unity of this nation. Above everything, Lord, we pray that, Lord, we'll be able to continue as brothers and as sisters, Lord, holding our hands together, knowing that you are in control, knowing that you order our steps, knowing that you guide us, knowing that you lead us, and that, Lord, where you lead us is that place that is a beautiful place that you want us to be in. Father, we thank you. And so we come to you this evening with thanksgiving. We have waited for this day. One of those things that we thank you, Lord, for is that so far, Lord, you've allowed us to hold together as a nation. And we pray that even at the end of everything else, Lord, as results trickle in, and even as the final announcement will be made, my Father, we will continue to be peaceful, O God, as a people and as a nation. Thank you, Lord, that by your grace, the campaigns, Lord, by and large, they have been peaceful, and we thank you because we know that you are going to carry us through. That, Lord, beyond today, beyond even the day that the final results will be announced, we want to refuse the schemes of the evil one, that, Lord, you will remain sovereign in this nation. Father, we pray and we thank you for those that you've given the mandate, the IEBC, oh God, to collate, Lord, and to tally, oh God, the results and those polling materials and the voting, oh God. We pray that you will guide them. We pray that you will lead them. We pray that you will give them sobriety. We pray that you will give them objectivity. Lord, we pray that that independent body, IEBC, Lord, we pray for your protection upon them. We pray for your protection upon their families. That, Lord, everything, Lord, as it comes, will be to honor you and to give you all the glory. We pray, Lord, also for those that there are names who are on the ballot. There are those that, Lord, will win, and there are those that will not necessarily win. But above all, as we've subjected ourselves to your sovereignty, we pray that we will accept, knowing that indeed it's the Lord that has led us, O Father. Father, we pray that everything, Lord, will bring glory and honor to your name. We pray that you'll continue to unite us as a nation. Father, We pray also that after all is said and done, as a people, we will be able to continue to rest in you, to know that you are in control, and to know, Lord Jesus, to know, my Father, that tomorrow we can be able to go on with our activities, that tomorrow we'll be able to go on with our duties, knowing that, yes, you have seen us through this election. And so some polling stations are closing now. Some may have closed. Some results are beginning to trickle in. But through the entire process, we pray that you will guide and that, Lord, there will be peace throughout. We bless you, my Father. We give you all the honor and we give you all the glory. For this we ask, trusting and believing in Jesus' name. And so once again, we thank the Lord for hearing our prayers. And we thank the Lord that he's a great God. And so the songwriter says, our God is greater. Our God is greater than even the elections. Our God is greater than all circumstances of our lives. And so, wonderful people of God, as we finish this service, I want to pray that the Lord bless you. And I want to pray that the Lord keep you. I want to pray that the Lord make his face to shine upon you and that the Lord will give each and every one of you peace. How I pray for the protection of God through this season. Those that may be traveling, we pray for the cover of God. Pray that the Lord bless you as you go out, that the Lord bless you as you come in. Above all, we pray for the blessings of God in our nation and in our country, Kenya. We thank you that, Lord, even in our national anthem, we pray that you, O God, is the God of all creation. That we want you to bless our land and our nation. And that, Lord, justice be our shield and defender. And that after all is said and done, we will dwell together in unity. And once again, may the Lord bless you. In the name of God, who is the Father, and who is the Son, and who is the Holy Spirit, and we all together said, amen, amen, amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. So I need you to move from side to side with us. Come on, hey, come on, come on, hey.
Lord, you are high.
like you.
No one like you.
None like you.
None like you.
Our God is greater. On the bass guitar. Mr. Kent, can you do something for us? Hey. One more time, Kent. I would have played bass, but I can't.
Watch
out. On the drums, over to the drums. Brother, all the way from Sitam Meru. Ay, 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 ay. Amo. Go, Amos. Go, Amos. Come on. Hey. The MD for the band. Engineer, freshly graduated, looking for a job. Whoever's watching,
Bwana engineer. Engineer Kunta himself. Come on, Kunta. One more time.
God is greater, you say. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. Lord, you are.